Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
The World Economic Forum in Davos begins tomorrow, and leading the Indian contingent is Commerce and Industry Minister Piyush Goyal. Well, this comes at a time when Goyal has been controversial regarding his remarks about Amazon and Flipkart. But what we want to look at in government matters today is what is India's strategy and approach at Davos at a time when it seems to be sending conflicting messages on the economy front to the world. Joining me in the studio, there's Noinima Basu, who tracks diplomacy for The Print. Noinima, let's talk a little bit about Davos first before we go on to talk about Indian representation there this year. What happens there? What typically happens at the World Economic Forum? Maybe we can demystify it a little bit.
Well, that's an interesting question, Ruhi. See, Davos, for over the years, I would rather say decades, we've seen this, global sort of jamboree that we see of all CEOs coming from, you know, top companies around the world. Ideally, this was a place, they do it in a place like Davos, where people can brainstorm and, you know, they can talk freely, right, how to invest in each other's company, and also look at some policy measures that are required to boost, you know, investments, especially in growing markets like India and all.
Right. And this is the 50th year of Davos.
This is the 50th anniversary, yes.
So from India, who all are going? What does the contingent look like?
So from India this time, the response had been a bit lukewarm, although we have our Commerce and Industry Minister Piyush Goyal going there, but Prime Minister Narendra Modi is not going. But then Minister Goyal is carrying a huge contingent of Indian CEOs and some ministers.
Right. So why is it that PM Modi is not going? Is there a message behind that, or is it a scheduling issue?
I think, officially there has been no response, but yes, he's preoccupied with a lot of domestic issues, as we can see, especially concerning the Citizenship Amendment Act and the fact that, you know, right now in India also quite many important visits are going to take place. We are having the Brazilian president coming up for the first time in India for the Republic Day. So, you know, a lot of preparations are going on. And then there are this thing going on that President Trump can also be coming very soon.
Right, so. In fact, you broke that story. So do log on to theprint.in to read Noinima's story on that. Noinima, now, as I mentioned in my introduction, Mr. Goyal has been controversial over the last 1 week because of his statements about Amazon chief Jeff Bezos, about what he said in interviews, in fact, just as late as yesterday, about Amazon and Flipkart. From that approach, going to a world forum like this, going to a global economic forum like this, what message is India really sending out?
So India is basically trying to tell the world, and I was there that day when Minister Goyal spoke about Amazon and Flipkart at the Raisina dialogue. It was a plain and simple question from the audience, but then he chose to go a bit longer on that. So basically what India is trying to portray is the fact that India is a place to do business where there'll be transparency, and no global CEOs, no matter how powerful you are, can be to the extent of Jeff Bezos. Do not try to look at loopholes in Indian laws, follow the laws, and then do your business. So, and he was very clear in that, stating, you know, we want to portray to the world that India is a place where we do business, but in a very transparent manner. What he meant by that, that is anybody's guess. So.
Sure, but you know, the words he chose were fairly harsh. He said Amazon is not doing India any favor by investing $1 billion and so on and so forth. And at a time when India is looking to invite foreign investment, when the economy needs that, and just ahead of an important meet like Davos, does that send out some kind of a disappointing message to the rest of the world?
Yes, I mean, that goes without saying, especially when you are sitting in a, you know, on a major platform like Raisina Dialogue. Like, over the years, it has gained some kind of traction, and that day the room was full. It was packed with CEOs and global leaders, political leaders, think tankers. So to say such a thing, that you're not doing a favor by investing in India, is something that gives a very wrong messaging, even to those who are contemplating to enter India just because of its sheer size and, you know, the market. And that is India's only USP at this point of time. I mean, when India is able to sort of do a lot of firefighting, be it on the Article 370 or on CAA or other issues, India always portrays the fact that we are this big market, so we don't have to worry about anybody. So And lines are really blurred between today between diplomacy, geopolitics, and business. So the fact that when you say things like that, you're even scaring the investors away. There are others who are criticizing your domestic policy. So what is it that you're trying to achieve end of the day?
What is it that you're trying to achieve is an important point to end your question answer with, because I want to understand what India is looking to do at this year's World Economic Forum in Davos. Is there a strategy? Is there a plan?
Davos has always been a place where you network with CEOs, tell them how good it is to invest in your particular country. India will definitely talk about the ease of doing business, which is something that this government has been constantly, talking about. And rightly so, because the rankings are improving. But then there are investors who have already spoken about the fact that ease of doing business is just one ranking. There are several other procedural issues. There are several other administrative issues, regulatory issues that you need to address to really have investment coming in. Now we are also seeing, with slowdown hitting China to some extent, the share of the pie is being taken away by Vietnam.
Right.
We are not able to be
leverage
a hook for those companies who are shifting out of China, but then they are going to Vietnam, they are not coming to India. So that should be a huge cause of concern for the government, especially that Mr. Goyal should be doing in Davos.
Right. So does Mr. Goyal have other meetings lined up? Are there other important interactions he's scheduled
to
have?
So he will be having a sort of bilateral meetings with his counterparts, probably from Canada, Australia and others, but there'll be a mini sort of WTO meeting, the World Trade Organization, where some of the key members, they will get together and talk about the fact that what lies for the WTO, the road ahead is all blocked by the US. And now US has done a separate deal with China after all those trade war that we saw between them. So he has a WTO meeting parallelly. We'll see what happens. He was very critical of the WTO also the other day in Raisina dialogue, where he said India is all for multilateralism, but some of the agenda for which India had come in, they have sort of died down. So it remains to be seen what they discuss. But
right. But will there be any conversation between Mr. Goyal and his counterpart from the US or whoever the representative is on the trade agreement between India and US?
I do not think that will be there, because that is anyway, for Davos separately, they don't need to meet. But the US State Representative Robert Lighthizer and Piyush Goyal, they keep talking all the time. And we get to hear now that the India-US, whatever small trade deal that they'll be doing, it's all finalized. The other day, Mr. Goyal also spoke about the fact that India plans to do a free trade agreement or a PTA, preferential trade agreement, with the US, in the longer run. So that intention is very much there. Whether they meet on the sidelines of Davos, that I do not know. But President Trump is going to be there, so he might say one line on India and the fact that he's looking at the trade deal with India. So.
Right. So it's interesting that President Trump is going to be there, and this also comes at a time when there are heightened tensions between the US and Iran. Would there be any conversation around that?
Yes, so he is going to be subjected to a lot of, questioning as to what was the need in doing what they did in Iran with the assassination of Qasem Soleimani, and the fact that what will be the larger implication, because we've seen after 9/11 and after the ensuing war on terror in Afghanistan how the world dynamics had been. So this is also that kind of a cusp that the world is standing in. Maybe Iran is now talking of playing it down and de-escalation. Other countries are also talking about it, but it really depends on what President Trump will do. President Trump may not be going for the war sort of euphoria right now, because he has to get the Taliban deal signed in Afghanistan,
right,
which will again have an indirect impact on India as well.
Right.
So these are interesting
things.
So
when is Mr. Goyal slated to return?
So he will be returning. The Davos meeting is till 24th, but we've seen generally ministers do not stay that long.
Right.
So maybe 25th, 24th evening he'll be back.
Right. Well, after his remarks of the last week, let's see what he does have to say there and how he approaches foreign CEOs and international investors, as you pointed out. Thank you so much for watching Government Matters. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.